Enjoy Artios Academy's production of Mary Poppins.
Woo!
Show your authority when interviewing staff. They know their role. You know your station. Efficiency and forethought cut the jobs in half. briefcase!
I thought Kitty now would be fun with the children. She always looks so cross.
Winifred, never confuse efficiency with a liver complaint.
I don't think we can find someone like your old nanny.
I'm afraid that's not possible, my dear. Few women alive could manage Miss Andrew's standards of efficiency.
Procedure and order, we will stop in a mess. It's like an old Paris.
We're in a mess.
The wonder, the nerve is fortunate.
Then place an advertisement in the Times stating that Jane and Michael Banks require the best possible nanny at the lowest possible wage.
The best is the lowest possible wage, they're making a mistake!
And I would stress that they are...
What's that you're holding, dear?
Wait, it's not an advertisement.
What on earth is the meaning of this?
I think we should hear it.
Winifred, none of your theatrics.
Please, don't. I think we should hear it. Wanted a nanny for two adorable children.
Well, that's debatable, I must say.
If you want this choice position, have a cheering disposition, rosy cheeks, no warts.
That's the part I put in.
Play games, all sorts, you must be kind, you must be witty, very sweet and very pretty.
Oh, ridiculous things.
Take us on outings, give us treats.
Indeed. Settle then. As long as I'm satisfied. Mary Poppins.
Yes.
Jane, don't stare.
And close your mouth, you're not a codfish. Best foot forward, spit foot.
Practically perfect in every way. Practically perfect, that's my forte.
chin chin, chin chin chirrup.
I does what I likes and I likes what I do.
Today I'm a screamer, and as you can see, a screamer's an artist of highest degree. And it's all me own work, from me own memory.
Oh, line up these again.
Go on, Mr. Popkeeper. It's just me pictures like it always is, there's no harm in them.
Oh, I'll be the judge of that. This is my park and I say you're interfering with the public railing. And I want to remove this... Well, that is, I, Just you watch it, that's all. Just you watch it.
Stay right there. I know that silhouette anyway. It's Mary Poppins!
It's nice to see you, Bert.
I must say, you do look swell.
He knows you? He can't know you. You've only just arrived.
I was not born but a little before I walked into your house, Michael Bates. Have you met these two, Bert?
Yes, I've seen him running about chasing a kite.
It isn't a real kite.
So, what are you guys up to?
Mary Poppins says it's a game. It's called A Walk in the Park.
Some game. I'd rather eat spinach.
Come on, Bert. You're due for a break, and you promised you'd take me out to meet him. Have you forgotten?
Yeah, of course I am, Harry. But,
Oh, dear. Is that all you've got?
Never mind my treat. And no one's charging for the trees in the sky, are they? Mary Poppins, is he really coming with us? And why shouldn't you?
Well, to start with, he's very dirty, isn't he? Father would never approve.
What's that? You're not coming with us. You're too dirty, and we don't want to be in the stinky park anyway.
Of course you do. Can we go to the park with Mary Poppins? You go to places that you've never dreamed of.
And if she says it's a game, then she's got something in mind. You can be certain of that.
That's a picture of the park, isn't it?
That's not the park. Not our park, anyway. Look, that tree is a much brighter green, and the sky is quite a different blue.
I think you'll find it's just the way I've drawn it. All that it takes is a spark, then something plain as a park. It becomes the Wonderland!
Have you ever seen the grass so green? Or a blue moon?
old friend of my father.
Your father? But you can't have a father. You're a statue.
Well, if that's true, why do I miss him very much?
Isn't he one of the other statues?
No. He is very far away from here.
Do you really miss him?
Wouldn't you miss your father if you hardly ever saw him?
I'll have to think about that.
That's what it was! What? The plinth's half empty, the statues are gone!
Do you mean you lost your marbles?
This is your fault, isn't it? Ever since you've been here,
Of course I will. I'm not going anywhere.
Then we'll see you soon. Goodbye, Nelia.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Anything can happen
if you let it.
How long will you stay?
Listen.
You won't leave us, will you, Mary Poppins?
I'll stay until the wind changes. When am I going?
Good night, Jane. Good night, Michael. Good night, Mary.
Good night, Poppins.
Tell them you've given me the message.
Short, please.
So the wives can do charity work and entertain. Speaking of which, how is your tea party coming on?
I'm not quite sure. It seems a bit odd to send out invitations to people I hardly know.
Oh, but they're people you should know. Remember, by your friends shall ye be judged.
But that's just it. They're not my friends. In fact, I spoke to Clemmie Bunting today. She told me that she's rehearsing a new play at the moment, and I thought...
Wait, how many times must I tell you, I wish you to sever all connection from that part of your life.
George, I was an actress. Lots of people might find that interesting, but you always seem to act as if it's something I should be ashamed
of. Well, it's not exactly something to be proud of. Winifred, dearest, I'm only looking out for you. I want people to respect you, to admire you.
No, George, but sometimes it's hard.
It's not hard. It's your job to be Mrs. Banks.
What is your job?
To pay for everything. What? What is it?
I was just going to kiss you goodnight.
Oh. All right. Are you going to say something to Mary Poppins about this afternoon?
I don't think so.
Very well. Just make sure she's doing things our way and not hers. What good are rules if you can bend them? We need a nanny who is disciplined and stern. With boys and girls, you don't befriend them. I fear that Mary Poppins has a lot to learn.
Yet it's one which I don't seem too good at. On the whole, I have a comfy home. I have a simple life. I have a name which
think we should wait until then, ma'am. Why not go up and get changed? Make clear up, won't we?
But I'm not ill! I won't take it, and you can't make me!
In that, as in so many other things, your information is faulty. Everyone!
It's strawberry ice!
Thank you! I'm not sure I like strawberry ice. I'm not sure that I care. Nine cordial. Now, I'll go, you two. Michael, I know you like to keep things neat. Jay?
I told you she was tricky.
Mary Poppins, must we?
Contact Robinson. I just do it when he wakes up. He is a servant.
With that attitude, you'll get through a lot of stuff before you're very old. Besides, in every job that must be done, there is an element to find. You find the fun and snap the jobs again. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake.
Guests, they're not coming, none of them. Do you suppose we chose the wrong day? No, ma'am. I suppose you chose the wrong people.
Kisses and all that stuffy nonsense.
Didn't they mind?
mine. They were glad to be rid of me. What's the matter?
Poor Daddy.
Poor. Poor, that's what made me the man I am today. Eh, Mary Poppins?
Yes, I'm afraid it did.
Well, you've seen where I work. I have a great deal to do.
Daddy, when you invest in the bank's money, what are you looking for? A good man? Or a good idea?
Well, I should say it's a good idea. But a good man is much rarer and much more valuable.
Come along, children.
A man with dreams. Mr. Von Hustler, I've considered your arguments, but the answer is no.
So you don't recognize a good idea?
Perhaps not, but I recognize a good man when I see one.
You're gonna regret this, Eric!
Thanks. That life hasn't broken. A man with hopes, ambitions to fulfill. A man you're certain at first glance deserves a chance. Mr. Northbrook, when did you say the factory could open?
Thank you, sir. You won't regret it.
Well, he's
barking.
You were saying? Really? Well, if she keeps wandering off like that, perhaps it'd be best if you kept her on the lead.
Willoughby!
Oh, look, here she comes now.
Willoughby! It's all right. What is he doing? No, sometimes it's almost as if he could talk.
But can Willoughby really talk?
Of course he can. Getting him to stop is the problem.
Have you learned to talk, dog?
How do you think? Master the grammar.
Practice when you can.
And avoid mongrels.
Far too much slang.
Now come along. I can't stand here all day talking shop.
Talking shop? What a silly expression.
There's nothing silly about it in the least.
Well, what do you buy at a talking shop?
Oh, conversations, of course.
But I've never seen a talking shop.
Well, there was only one, and it belongs to Mrs. Corey.
Who's Mrs. Corey?
Who's Mrs. Corey?
Mrs. Corey has to be the oldest person in the line.
She talked to William, the boy when conquering, Vlad before he went in pale, and Alexander before he went so bright.
You'll have to call it a shop in the park. But there is no shop in the park. Remember, anything can happen if you let it.
Well, if it isn't Mary Poppins with Jane and Michael Banks.
She knows us.
And how is poor little Georgie?
Who?
Georgie Banks. It's your father. He used to be his lazy slip and come into my shop here in secret.
But it can't be the same George Banks. It had to be 40 years ago. And no one can remember back that long.
Listen, Dee Dee, I remember everything. I remember Georgie used to love my gingerbread stars. I wonder if we've got any left. Annie, Fanny, look lively.
Yes, Mother.
Here you are, gingerbread pieces with gingerbread stars.
Georgie always saved his stars.
Now, Nelly Poppins, what can I do for you?
Well, I did want an ounce of conversations.
I'm all out of conversations, and I'm right out of words, too. You see, I've got quite a lot of chatterboxes in here today. But let me see what we have left. I do have a few letters, and a bit of back chat. An ounce, you say? That'll be 15 letters. Go on, take your pick.
Jane, you can choose seven.
Well, I see a D, G, R, U. C, M, and I.
Very good. You can't make a conversation after them.
Your turn, Michael. Seven more.
I choose an A, an S, S, E, T, O, and P.
And I'll choose an S. Ooh. Now, what do I have to make? Well, let's talk.
Lab of Fritis. That's 11. Maybe there.
Those don't count.
You made them up.
And where did the same words came from in the first place?
Yeah, you can always use the same letter more than once. Super. Calif. Vaginistic. Expialidocious.
Oh, that's the word.
Of course it's a word. And unless I'm very much mistaken, I think it's going to prove to be a rather useful one. When trying to express oneself, it's frankly quite absurd to leave the lengthy hexacons to find the perfect word. A little spontaneity keeps conversation weak. You need to find a way to say precisely what you mean. Supercalifragilistic, speculadidacious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious. Say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
I'm dealing with a little.
Don't need to be chatting, simply writing, so that's
it. Oh, they're with me, Bernice.
Right, now you stay there and Mr. Mac, you are never coming out of that face door, no one else but me either. That is an heirloom.
Oh, an heirloom.
Now while I do this, stay totally immobile.
Immobile.
Do not move a muscle.
A muscle.
Do not even breathe.
German chap alone. He went to our chief rivals, they gave him the money. And it seems it's turned into a gold mine.
Oh, my dear, they can't expect you to get it right every time, can they?
Can't they? That's exactly what they expect.
Oh, super califragilistic, expialidocious, even though the sound of it is solely quite atrocious. If you say
that's
it.
That's more than loud enough! Go to your rooms now!
But we were just.
I don't care what you were just upstairs now! Where's my briefcase? Michael! Jane! Will you give it to me? Must I put up with this behavior? You're their mother! Why can't you do something about it?
Try not shouting for stop.
Mary Poppins, you are here to teach the children manners and just look at them. They are a pair of little savages. If I had my way, you would be out of this
house! You're tired!
Mary Poppins, take the children upstairs. Mr. Banks is quite exhausted.
I hope you haven't forgotten that. Tonight I mean out. What?
I had forgotten. I suppose the best people wouldn't ask you to change plans.
No, ma'am, they wouldn't. It's not fair. Daffy loses his temper and was shut up in the nursery. Daffy's mean and rotten. And I hate him!
Jane, take that back as insult. I will not have to criticize your father!
Why not? He criticizes you. Last week he said you were neither used nor ornament.
How dare you?
I haven't said it, and so did you.
Sometimes people say things they don't mean. Take them upstairs, Mary Poppins. George.
What is it?
Thought you might like to talk about it.
What would be the point?
I could help.
Don't be ridiculous.
George, if you have troubles, I want to share them.
Don't worry, you will. The fact is, I've been suspended without salary until the bank decides what to do with me.
Same about you.
Why does Daddy get so cross?
Father says
supposed to look after the children, not yell at them all the time.
Maybe, but have you asked yourself who looks after the fathers when things go wrong?
The mothers, I suppose.
Not the children? Wouldn't that be rather upside down? Sometimes families are upside down. For a while, anyway.
But I don't want to be in an upside down family.
I wish I could run away.
Why don't you? Somebody might adopt you.
But you'd miss me.
No, I wouldn't. I've left all your toys.
No, you cannot.
Oh, yes, I could, and I jolly well would.
Give me that. Stop it, Jim.
Now look what you've done.
That's no way to treat Valentine.
What's he ever done to you?
He's only a doll, silly.
That couldn't do anything.
That's it, you two. Now into bed at once.
But we haven't had our milk.
There'll be no buts, and there'll be no milk either. If you can't be good, you may as well be sorry.
Well, we want to go to bed, and you can't make us.
In that, as in so many other things,
your information
is faulty.
Thank you. Embers.
hardly no day, and hardly no night. The things up in shadows and halfways in light. On the rooftops of London. What a sight.
Oh, so you're asleep now, are you?
It's the best view in the world, eh? And who gets to see it?
Birds, the stars, the chimney sweeps. Now as the ladder of the life has been shrunk, your mind thinker sweeps at the bottommost rung. Now I spend me time in the ashes and smoke. In this old white world there's no happier look. Chim chimmy, chim chimmy, chim chim chimmy. My sweep is as lucky can be. Chim chimmy, chim chimmy, chim chim chimmy. And that's lucky too.
So you're going then?
The wind has changed.
But the good kids, then?
Would I be bothered with them if they weren't? But I can't help them if they won't let me, and there's no one so hard to teach as the child who knows everything.
So?
So they've got to do the next verse on their own. Chim chimmy, chim chimmy, chim chim chimmy. When you're with a sweep, you're in bad company. Goodbye, Bert.
Chim, 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 chimmy. When you're with a sweep, you're in glad company. Nowhere is there more happy a crew than them to sing chim, chim, chimmy, chim, chim.
Surprise!
You know very well I hate surprises at the best of times, but
oh, not this one. I
to believe you're going to like this one and be proud of me for once.
Precision and order is perfectly true. Can really make a difference. I found her for you. The thinking, sound judgment, and now we regain a home you can be proud of and cherry tree lane.
Hurry up, everyone, into the hall. I want you to find everything.
Spit, spot, spit, and spit.
You know, I never thought I'd say this, but I'm disappointed. Your friend. I ain't gonna hurt you.
Oh, but it's you. You're filthy.
Perhaps as much as do. So I've been staying on Chippy's room. So, what's the matter? Who's after you?
The nastiest nanny in the world.
The nastiest nanny in the world, eh? Well, you two should know. You've been through enough of her. Is she really as bad as all that?
She looks like something that would eat its young.
It's actually Daddy's nanny, which explains a lot.
Poor Daddy. Ever since he stopped working, he just sits and mopes. Mary Poppins used to say he needs alcohol. But now it's too late.
I wouldn't say that. I'll tell you what. Why don't we start things off with a bit of a shakes for good luck?
Why would shaking hands with you bring us luck?
Hasn't anyone ever told you? It's lucky the shaker sweeps a hand.
But what do you do when you need some luck?
Well, I shake hands with myself. What do we have here?
Look, look, it's a real one. What's the matter? You always wanted to fly a little kite.
I've always wanted to fly one with Daddy.
Of course you have. Well, first you need to learn how it's done. Get some training in. We'll make your father the proudest in the whole country.
Do you really think so? You're not just saying that.
The whole country? I say the whole country, the whole blooming empire, right? With your feet on the ground, you're a bird in flight, with your fist holding tight to the string of your kite.
Now see here! It's against regulations coming down from the sky like that!
illusions may shatter, but memories stay. The things that really matter I lost on the way. The sovereign, the master, and long may he reign. The famous good for nothing of Cherry Tree Lane.
Face didn't have enough practice.
But this time they're not being naughty. I'm afraid I've made them unhappy. I'm afraid I've made everyone unhappy.
Now turn up, don't you worry.
George, dear, I know it hurts your pride, dear, but you can't just run and hide, dear.
Well, I think we know what's needed now.
insolent young person, how dare you speak to me in this way?
Silly little girl, I'm your real favourite. I bring up children so they know their place. That's your tradition, my girl, my child.
Mishandle charges blow up in your face.
I rolled up their father.
Well, that's all I don't doubt. He must be so proud of the way he turned out.
A shining example of
Winifred, if I am to be dismissed by the bank,
will be destitute. The house will be repossessed, the servants will leave, and we shall sit on the frosty curbside with the children.
But we'll still have what really matters. The children.
In all weathers of all hours. It's happened. The chairman wants to see me at the close of business tonight.
Tonight? Well, I'm going to come with you and show you how to do it.
I'm afraid that would only make matters worse. So we'd better make some plans. In fact, I think the time is coming.
Why are you talking about another space? Watch Mr. Terrible.
Needs must, my dear. We always said we were saving it for a rainy day, but tomorrow it looks fit to fall. Excellent advice. What did you spend them on?
Nothing yet. We kept them. And now we've decided to give them to you.
Well, I suppose Mary Poppins put you up to this.
No. She hasn't said a word about it. But we know it's been difficult for you lately. We haven't really been much help.
We thought a little extra cash might loosen things up a little.
It's the whole shilling.
Thank you.
Good night, Daddy. We do love you, you know?
Good night. Jane, do you remember when you asked me about Neelisa's father?
Yes.
It was Poseidon, king of the sea.
Good night.
Anything can happen if you let it. How'd you do it? You turned down a scandal that was about to make millions, and we want to know why.
Very well. I'll tell you. I refused Mr. Von Hustler because his scheme was hollow. It had no product. It had no substance. It had no meaning outside the walls of the bank. Oh yes, he told me about assets and profits and growth. But there was no word about people. Now I know, gentlemen, that as far as you're concerned, if a man puts any value on real life, he's a washout. But I'm afraid I do value it, gentlemen. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. I apologize for ruining the bank, but I do not apologize for realizing that there are more important things in life than making money.
Ruining the bank? Ruining the bank, my dear chap, what are you talking about? You saved our bank, then, have you not heard? Well, thus the scheme has ruined our rival. You saved the bank.
Oh my
God. We're not asking for your apology, we're offering ours. And another thing, do you remember giving a loan to a chap named Northbrook? Well, he's repaying it, and he's opening two new factories. With the percentage you negotiated, we're set to make a fortune.
Oh my word.
That's just it, Mr. Banks. We'd like to know exactly how you did it. Just give us the word and it'll be safe for us.
Give you the word? Give you the word? I'll give you the word. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. You really sounded something quite atrocious.
Told me everything I know.
Then now's your chance to forget it.
Yes, and you want to
wait, dearest, I haven't lost the paper on you at all. In fact, I made them a fortune.
Really?
Yes, it's wonderful.
Okay, gentlemen, we still have some business to discuss, madam, if you don't mind. Ah, all right. Well. Thanks, George. George, we'd like to offer you a new job as senior manager of the bank with double your salary.
Exactly how much has he made you?
Triple your salary. Quadruple your salary.
Oh my word. Yes, I accept. Under one condition. From now on, my family comes first.
Agreed?
Agreed.
Thank you so much, yes.
However, could you forgive me?
How could you ask?
Well, it was selfish of me to keep you off the stage, and I'm sure you'd like to return. I wouldn't mind.
Yes. I think I found a ball that I love. It is going to keep me busy for a very long time.
Outside outish.
not for a very long time. You can always keep an eye on the stars until you return them. Yeah. Well, it's your turn, Sam. So it is. Keep it if you'd like. It's a present. Thank you. Now run along before it starts getting cold. I love you, Mary Poppins. You are a fine boy, Michael Pinks. And one day you'll grow up to be a fine old man. Oh, Mary Poppins, it makes me so anxious when you talk like that.
Like what?
Oh, kind and gentle and not a bit like you. Be cross, Mary Poppins. Do be cross again.
Is that the thanks for the trouble I've taken in?
That's better.
That's dainty, Bert.
They're yours. I painted them. For you. It's tonight, isn't it?
Yes, Bert.
Goodbye, Mary Poppins.
Goodbye, Bert. Look after yourself.
Winifred, my dearest love.